Hey guys, it's Parav from PD Tech HD, and a few weeks ago I was at Microsoft's Victoria offices to try out the Surface Pro 3. Does Microsoft's latest tablet have what it takes to be the best of the tablet and laptop worlds? Let's get started. Along the left hand side you have the headphone jack, the volume rocker, and at the bottom there's a groove for you to get your finger under to expand the kickstand. More on that a bit later. Switching to the right, you'll find a mini DisplayPort adapter, a full-size USB 3.0 port, and a microSD card slot, allowing you to expand the storage an extra 128GB as well. On the back, you'll find a 5MP camera, a stereo microphone, and the Surface branding. Up top, you'll find the sleep-wake button, which has a nice tactile feel, like the volume rocker. I asked you guys on Twitter to tell me what questions you had on the Surface Pro 3, and I posed them to Ian Molster, one of Microsoft's product managers.
Hi, my name is Ian Molster. I'm with the Windows team here at Microsoft in the UK. You know, there's a lot of difference, a lot of things have changed, a lot of things have improved based on feedback we received. I'll run through just a few of them very quickly. It's a bigger screen. It's a 12-inch screen versus a 10.6-inch screen. It's more square shaped, 3x2 rather than 16x9, means you get a lot more on your screen. But incredibly, although it's a bigger screen, it actually weighs less than it did, and it's a third thinner as well. So it's really thin, doesn't weigh very much. Nice big screen. Some of the things that have changed, the keyboard's improved. You can now rest the keyboard up against the screen so you get a bit of a slope on it. The trackpad's improved quite a lot. The sound's got louder and it's improved. The pen, a lot of work has been done on the pen, make it high quality with all sorts of really cool things you can do with the pen. There's a raft of stuff. It's really difficult to summarize them all. A lot of work's been put into listening to what people said about the first two products. And making sure we improved the product to based on the feedback we received from the first two.
First thing I noticed when I picked up the Surface Pro 3 was just how light and thin it is, coming in at only 800 grams and 0.63 inches thin. It's very comfortable to hold in either portrait or landscape orientation. The new continuous kickstand now easily adjusts to any angle up to 150 degrees. The Surface Pen has been improved, feeling a lot more weighty, like an actual pen. You can press the button on the top of the pen to open up OneNote to capture that quick idea, even if the tablet is locked. Double tapping this button allows you to take a screen grab of whatever size you want, and then it automatically is pasted into OneNote. The pen also now uses palm block technology, meaning you can lay your palm on the screen without it interrupting your writing experience, just like you write with a pen on paper.
So it's really cool. I mean, it's a really high-res screen. One of the other things that's changed, it's a higher, better than HD screen. 2360 by 1440 screen. Really clear, really bright. That more square shape and bit bigger screen means it's really nice to watch video, read books, read magazines and so on. A beautiful screen. Because it's got that more square shape, it works really well in both modes. So I use it in both reading my magazines and things. I have it in portrait mode because the page is really big and you just flip across. Then of course I'm working on a Word document, whatever. I've got it in landscape mode. But it feels good in the hand. It balances really nicely because of that changed shape. Yeah, it's a bit of both really. So, I mean, casual games, of course, it's very easy for the machine because it's a really powerful machine, so it has no trouble running those at all. And with the beautiful screen, they come out very well. You can run, obviously, you can run all your desktop apps, and therefore you can run desktop games. If you're running a really hardcore 3D desktop game, it will still run them. It runs them pretty well, to be honest. It's not a gaming machine as such, but it runs them pretty well, given that it's a Core i5 or Core i7 processor in there with other 4 or 8 gig of RAM. It's a pretty powerful bit of kit. So right from your really stressful games that stress it out all the way down to the low-end games, it runs them all pretty well.
The gaming experience in general is enhanced by the stereo speakers, which, although not on the front, are quite loud and clear. But here, listen for yourselves. The device did get fairly warm in the time I used it, but there is a perimeter vent all around the device's edges, and you really won't hear the fan unless you're doing very heavy tasks.
Yeah, there's been huge growth in the store. There's a lot of apps in there now, and really covering most of the things you'd want. If you find something that you want to do that's not in the store, very likely there'll be a desktop app that will do it as well. And of course, the desktop apps are incredibly rich. You can get professional music creation apps, professional photography apps, really anything that a Windows machine will run on here, because that's what it is. It's the same as a Windows laptop or a desktop in terms of what it will run.
Okay, thank you very much for your time, Ian.
Yeah, no trouble at all. Thanks a lot.
There are two useful accessories for the Microsoft Surface Pro 3. First, the Surface Pro Type Cover and the Surface Pro 3 Docking Station. The Type Cover is much larger than the previous versions and the trackpad is actually usable, since that's been made larger too. It also supports Windows 8's gestures, such as two-finger swipe to go to the next page on a particular website. The keyboard can be used either flat, or due to the magnetic mechanism, the keyboard can attach to the screen to give a more comfortable angle while typing. The keys have a nice feeling and sound when pressed. Here, listen for yourselves. When I used the Surface 2 previously, I avoided the trackpad because it was so small, but on the Surface Pro 3 it was a pleasure to use. The docking station converts your tablet into a full-size PC, allowing you to connect HD monitors, Ethernet, external speakers, a full-size keyboard and more, all while the Pro 3 is being charged. Inserting and removing the Pro 3 from the docking station is easy, thanks to the way it lines up with the device. You just slot it in and push the sides inwards. The Pro Pen also magnetically attaches to the docking station, quite nifty. Overall, I think Microsoft's onto a winner here with the Surface Pro 3. There are a wide range of configurations available, offering different processors and storage options, so check out the links in the description for more information such as the pricing as well. I really enjoyed using the trackpad on the new keyboard, and I think that's a great accessory for someone looking to make the most of their Pro 3 device. The docking station is also very useful and will help a lot of people that want to expand the capabilities further. I almost wish I had this device when I was a student at university. It would have allowed me to be a lot more efficient with my note taking. And think about how many times you have a great idea and it just passes you by. With the Pro 3, one click of the pen and you can treasure that thought. If you enjoyed this video, definitely drop it a like down below as that helps the channel. And let me know if you're considering picking up the Surface Pro 3 in a comment down below. For any current owners watching, if you have any feedback, be it positive or negative, do leave that down below and I'll be sure to pass it on to Ian. It may help the development of future products, who knows. For those of you wondering, I do have a fluid head tripod now, which is how I was able to achieve the shots in this video, so I hope you guys like the improvement. I'd like to thank Ian from Microsoft for this opportunity. Don't forget to subscribe for more tech content like this, and thanks again for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Take care.